Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco, and what you see behind me is actually my $5 million YouTube studio setup. No, it's not. It's just a green screen and a CGI image that I did. Anyhow, today I wanted to talk about two topics. First, how tutorial creation can actually benefit you as a CGI artist. And second, I'm going to be sharing a few tips on how I did this whole background thing. So, I started researching the possibility of doing tutorials I think 6 or 7 years ago, but I never kind of got the motivation or the time to do it. But along the way, people would constantly tell me, generally, don't do tutorials, like don't reveal your secrets, maybe show something basic that everybody knows, but like don't reveal, you know, the big guns. And at that point I was thinking, hold up, like 70% of the things that I know, I either read somewhere, saw a video about it, or somebody told me. You know, all these three things have one thing in common, and that's sharing the knowledge. So I decided, like, you know what the hell? I am going to do tutorials, and I am going to reveal whatever I know. And when I started recording for the first time, at that moment, it kind of occurred to my head, like, if you're going to record this topic, are you really 100% sure that what you're saying is legit? Now, that got me thinking, and that got me researching. So before doing every video, I would learn so many new things that my video would originally be extended by 1 or 2 extra minutes of new information. Not to mention, when I published the video, you guys jump in the comments saying all kinds of tips, all kinds of tricks. It literally blew my mind. I had no idea the reaction is gonna be like that. So if any of you are even considering maybe doing, you know, tutorial creation a go, trust me, do it. Like, your knowledge is gonna skyrocket. You're gonna learn so many new things. Not to mention, you're gonna get a bunch of new contacts, a bunch of people, you know, who are gonna kind of enter your inner circle. It's just, you know, it's a really cool experience. Now, there is a dark side of doing YouTube. YouTube or tutorials, it's extremely time consuming. So for example, for me, doing this video, it took me about 10 hours to record it. You know, you see my random videos, they're like 5 minutes, 6 minutes, 7 minutes long. Behind that, there's like at least minimum 4 to 5 hours of creating each one. It's just redoing takes, then something doesn't work, then you figure out that this could be said better. You know, all these tries and retries and retries, but in the end, it's extremely rewarding, and I highly recommend it. If you have something to say, just record a simple tutorial, everybody has a mic, and see how that goes. So now, let's talk about the background that I have behind me. Let me give you a few insights on how you can actually make that setup at your place. So first, let me show you how my room looks like. So it is pretty much this. The first thing that you need to know is what is the height of your camera that is recording. So you measure the height, place the camera in. Next, you need to know what millimeters you're using with your camera. After you set these up, next, you want to figure out what light sources are you dealing with. In my room, I only have one light source, and that is this one main studio light. And this studio light is literally positioned here. I also measured the height of it so that I know where the light is exactly coming from. And the next thing, and that's the final thing that I had to measure, was what is the distance between me and my camera. So I literally took a measuring tape and just measured the distance between the camera and myself. And this is the sphere that I have here. So this is my head. Why am I using this sphere? This is mainly for the focus purposes. If I want to add some natural depth of field behind me, I'm going to have this in my scene, and this is going to serve like a focus picker. Again, I do have some sort of mass. I do have this big chair behind me, so I didn't want to go into super detailed stuff, so I literally just added the box, and that box is kind of mimicking the shadow that is being cast behind me. So now, let me show you how does my light work actually. So this is the scene that I have. If I turn on my depth of field and crank it up a little bit, so we're gonna get something like this. So I can click on the focus, and just when I click here, everything else will have a natural depth of field. So when you're dealing with scenarios like this where you want to mimic stuff, you always want to mimic depth of field because it is an important part of the whole process. Now when it comes to lighting, so I have my main light, my studio light that I said, and that light is here. This is the main studio light. Next, I have the floor lamp. So floor lamp is this light. And then I'm left with the outside light, which is just subtly hitting the room. And I have my neon light here. And of course, this little 3D printer light, but it's not important. So the balance of these lights is very important. Usually these studio lights are very strong, so I had to kind of crank that up to have a much larger effect than this one does. I know the value here stays the same, but this really depends on the size of the light source, etc. And that's pretty much it. This is pretty much how I did the whole setup. Now, if you want to get a more realistic look into the room behind you, make sure to add things that really people don't assume that you are a millionaire. So try to add as much dirt as you can. Like, make everything uneven as much as you can. These are all the things that are gonna trick the brain into thinking that they're looking at the real photo. So let me show you this, for example. So if we go to the corner where this lamp is, you can see that I have all these paint mistakes on the wall. Now, these are very important. I know they are super subtle details, but your brain will register it as something imperfect. Also, try to add some dirt on the wall if you can. I don't know who drew this. This was not me. Anyhow, for example, this plant down here. You can see, you know, like in real life, if you have any plants at home, a few times you might notice that the dirt from the plant is kind of scattered around it. So I tried to kind of mimic that. So I have these here, just some dirt marks. I also try to add some sort of dirt to these doors, just so that it feels aged, because that's the biggest problem in CGI. Everything is perfect. Everything is super brand new. And I kind of wanted to avoid that. The floors were generally used with a technique that I showed in my previous video with the floor material. Now, these cabinets, they also have a heavy bump. Now, the reason I decided to put the heavy bump here is just to be noticed from afar. And you can literally add millions of details. You can even see I have some paint wear-offs here and there, etc. And for the final nail in the whole picture, when I rendered it out, I rendered it in double resolution, downscaled it to get extra details, and that's what you see behind me. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope to see some new tutorials popping up on YouTube, but take it easy and see you in the next one. Bye!